Hi everyone, Kevin here. Today, we're going to look at 5 Windows features that you probably didn't know about. And these are really good. Let's dive in. This brings us to number 1, the Snipping Tool. You might have heard of this tool before, but recently it's received lots of upgraded functionality that makes it very powerful. Here on my desktop, I have a PNG image of a job description, and I would like to copy some text from this, but I can't do it since it's an image. Down on the taskbar, go to the search field and then search for the Snipping Tool. You should see it right at the top as the best match. Let's click on this. This now launches the Snipping Tool, and here within the tool itself, you'll see a handy shortcut key that you can type in to launch the Snipping Tool directly into screenshot mode. And in a moment, we'll find out an even easier shortcut key to launch this app. Right up on top, let's click on New, and right here, let's highlight this entire image to bring this into the Snipping Tool. Once you highlight all of it, release. Right over here, let's now expand this window, and look at that. We now have a screenshot of an image. But wait until you see this functionality. Right up on top, there's an icon called Text Actions. And when we click on this, we see this rectangle around the text, and it now recognizes all of the text. And this part's really neat. Look at this. I can now highlight any of the text in this image. And right up on top, I can even copy all of the text onto my clipboard, and I can now paste this anywhere. It uses something called OCR, or Optical Character Recognition. Let's now go up to the top right-hand corner where we have the 3 dots and click on this, and down at the bottom, click into settings. Within settings, let's scroll down, and here we see the option to use the print screen key to open the Snipping Tool. I'll click on this, and this opens up Windows settings. And if we scroll down just a little bit, here we see the option. This way, you can simply press print screen on your keyboard, and that'll launch the Snipping Tool. That way, you don't have to press Windows, Shift, and S. Now, I think it's a little bit easier just to press 1 key versus 3. Let's now close out of settings, and this brings us back to the desktop. Now let's press Windows, Shift, and R. R is in record. And this too also opens up the Snipping Tool, but it drops us into screen record mode. Over here, I can highlight a portion of the screen that I would like to screen record. I'll release. Right up on top, I can decide whether I want to record my microphone and whether I want to record system audio. Once I'm ready to record, I'll simply click on start. Here I see a countdown timer, and now it'll record my screen. Right up on top, when I'm all done, I'll click on stop. This brings us to number 2, Notepad. It's been part of Windows since the very beginning, with version 1.0 back in 1985. Here I have Notepad open, and first off, you'll notice it now supports dark mode. Pretty cool. Let's type in some text. The Kevin Cookie Company is the best. I'll press Control and scroll my mouse wheel to zoom in, or here I could zoom out. A nice little shortcut key. Now here's one thing I like. In the top right-hand corner, I'll close out of Notepad, and let's reopen Notepad. And there you'll see that it automatically saves my text. It's a nice new feature. And who would have known, but Notepad has also jumped onto the AI bandwagon. In the top right-hand corner, we have this icon called Rewrite. When I click on it, we can rewrite the text. There's also a shortcut key. Make it shorter, make it longer. You can also change the tone. And here you have a few different options. And we could also change the format here too, also with a few different options. So there you get AI writing capabilities directly within Notepad. This brings us to number 3, Microsoft Paint. This app has also jumped on the AI bandwagon. In the top right-hand corner, you have 2 different AI features, the Image Creator and the Co-Creator. With Co-Creator, you describe the image you would like to create, like let's say an island with a palm tree. Then you start drawing on the canvas. AI will enhance what you're drawing. I'll add a palm tree. Here I can add some water. I'll also add a boat. With the boat, I have to go back and refine my prompt so the AI knows it's a boat and not just another island. Once I'm all done, I can add it to the canvas. Overall, I think that looks pretty good. With the Image Creator, you simply describe what type of image you want, and then it'll generate an AI image using DALL-E 3 on the back end. There's also some additional new functionality included in Paint. Over on the left-hand side, I'll drag a photo into Paint, and this opens up my picture. Right up on the top toolbar under Image, there's the option to remove the background from a photo. I'll click on this, and there you see the background has just automatically disappeared. Another new feature, over on the right-hand side, you can now work with layers directly in Paint. I'll click on the layers icon, and here you see that I currently have one layer. I'll click on the plus icon, and that adds a new layer currently on top of this photo. But let's move this layer to the bottom. And here I can now paste in a background behind this photo. Look at that masterpiece. This brings us to number 4, clipboard history. Here I am in a Word document, and I'd like to copy the title here, so I'll highlight that, press Control C. I'd also like to copy the meeting objective, I'll press Control C and copy that. And I also like this image, I'll press Control C. Now, I'll jump over to PowerPoint where I'm pulling together a deck, and I'd like to paste in that title. Now, instead of pressing Control V to paste, let's press Windows V. And this opens up my clipboard history, showing me all the different items that I recently copied. And there's that title. I'll click on that, and that pastes it in. Over here, I'll press Windows V. Let me paste in the meeting objective and Windows V again. And here, I'll paste in the image. So that way, you can copy multiple items, and you could also paste multiple items. This brings us to number 5, Microsoft Edge, which comes pre-installed with Windows. On my desktop, I have a PDF file, and I'd like to make a few lightweight edits to this file. I can do that in Edge. I'll click on the file, and that opens up my PDF. Up on top, I have various annotation tools. Here, for example, I have a highlighter. I'll click on this, and I can highlight some text. Next to that, I also have some drawing tools. Let me select red, and let's click here. And now I could draw on the document, or you could even say write a signature. And right over here, this is one of my favorites. I could click on this and I can now add text to my PDF. This is especially helpful if you need to fill out a PDF form, but you can't actually type on that form. So here, I could click there and let me add some text. This looks great. And once I'm all done, in the top right-hand corner, I can click on Save to save the PDF with all of these different annotations. And because I like you all so much, we have a bonus. If you've noticed that your computer is a little bit more sluggish compared to when you first bought it, it could be due to lots of different apps starting up when you boot up your computer. Down on your taskbar in the search field, type in Startup Apps. And right up above, we see the best match for startup apps in system settings. Let's click on that. And here you can see all the different apps that start up when you start your computer. And next to these different items, you'll also see what type of impact it has on your startup. For example, some of these, it says no impact, and some of them aren't measured. Now, down at the very bottom, I have the Xbox app, and I don't use that, and I don't need it to start up when I start my computer. So over here, I can toggle that off. Feel free to go through here and look at the apps that you use and the apps that you don't use, and feel free to toggle off the ones that you're not using. And you should notice that your startup time is a lot faster. Hopefully you learned some new ones. If you have any others to share, let me know in the comments. I'll see you next time.